Well, Brian Klaas teaches global politics at University College London. He also co-authored the book How to Rig an Election and is the author of The Despot's Apprentice, Donald Trump's Attack on Democracy. Brian, lovely to see you. So the president and his message have been silenced for now. What do you make of the timing and the coordination here?
Well, I think this is a megaphone that's been taken away from Donald Trump, and it's going to be something that he feels yet again aggrieved and parrots a victimhood complex. But, you know, I mean, we have to speak plainly about what happened this week. Donald Trump, for months, stoked insurrectionists who ultimately stormed the U.S. Capitol and resulted in the deaths of five people. And, you know, Twitter's terms of service are very clear about the fact that you cannot stoke violence on its platform. And we shouldn't carve out exceptions, no matter who you are, because the consequences of doing so are very, very real. And I think that's what we're going to be talking about as this story unfolds in the coming days.
So the consequences for this president are social media isolation and direct connection with his supporters. But those supporters and the platform's links to him and his conspiracy, Brian, have also been shut down. So my question is then, can this message of insurrection, as you call it, be dampened now? Or has this president managed to incite a movement that endures beyond this silence? I mean, he's promised long into the future.
Well, this is the very dangerous angle that I'm worried about. You know, I saw this coming last May when I wrote a column saying that Trump would reject the election results, would call the election rigged falsely, and then would cause violence, which his supporters would take up and lead to deaths. And what I'm seeing now is that this monster has been unleashed, right? Trump created it, the Republicans encouraged it, and now they can't control it. So, you know, we're not out of the woods yet. We have another 10 days of the Trump presidency, 11 days of the Trump presidency, and the inauguration is going to be a flashpoint. So I think law enforcement is going to be on very high alert. And of course, that's partly why Twitter acted, because they're worried about the reputational consequences of Trump continuing to incite violence, more people dying, and people pointing to his Twitter account and saying, why wasn't action taken? So in some ways, it was to cover themselves from the risk of being tarnished by a president who is directly inciting violence among supporters that he cannot control.
Van Jones, as always, very eloquent on Wednesday, said the question needed to be asked, was this the beginning or the end of something? Was this the violent death throes of a divisive presidency, or is this the beginning of perhaps domestic terror-like events where these supporters are targeting either the Biden presidency or the state itself? Both are pretty, you know, radical in terms of, you know, where you could be on the spectrum. Where do you see this moment?
Well, I think it is a beginning and an end. So it is an end in the sense that the elites in the Republican Party, people like Mitch McConnell, are finally acknowledging that Trump is dangerous, right? We knew he was for a very long time, but people who denied his danger are now accepting it and condemning him unequivocally. That's important. But at the same time, Trump has conditioned his base to cheer for authoritarian tactics, to cheer for encouragement of violence, to cheer for demonization of political opponents. And that does not end on January 20th. Trump has remade the Republican Party in his image. And so I think what you're going to see over the next 2 to 4 years is an internal fight within the Republican Party for its future. Is it going to try to return to the days of John McCain and the sort of decency that you saw in the Republican Party? Or is it going to continue with Trump 2.0s? And that's the fight that we're going to see. And unfortunately, the base is still on board with a lot of what Trump has done. We saw in a poll recently that about half of Republicans had some level of approval for insurrectionists violently storming the Capitol, resulting in the deaths of five people. This is a long-term problem, and it's something that was foreseeable, and Republicans made the bet that they could get away with enabling it, and now it has created some serious consequences that are on obvious display for all to see.
I also want to talk now about this second push to impeach the president. You talk about this as a president who, in many ways, wallows in victimhood. Is it necessary? Or do you agree, perhaps, with Lindsey Graham, who says this might incite or get Mr. Trump's supporters to see him as a victim, and that this is counterintuitive, essentially? Or do you think this is a way for the Republican Party to make its choice, potentially turn against him?
Well, I signed an open letter with around 2,000 political scientists calling for Trump to be removed from office for two reasons. One is the immediate threat, right? We have seen over the last several months that Trump lives in a delusional fantasy world. What he says regularly is untrue. It is fiction. And he's causing violence based on that fiction. I don't want to gamble with the next 11 days that something else doesn't happen, right? So that's one reason. The second reason is precedent. So if you don't impeach the president over this, you can't impeach future presidents over much more minor transgressions. You have to draw a line in the sand and say that if you incite violence in a way that causes the violent takeover of the United States Capitol, there are consequences. So even if the impeachment doesn't proceed quickly enough to get him out of office before January 20th, I still think it's worth doing to ensure that future presidents understand that if they behave like Donald Trump just did this week, there will be serious consequences for them. And it's also important to say that it'll be the first time in U.S. history that a president has been twice impeached, which will again stain his legacy, and that is important for precedent as well.
Brian Klaus, always good to speak to you and get your perspective. Thank you very much there. Life